Hi, good morning, traders. Today is 19th of March, Friday again. Wow, 1 week. Week after week passed so fast. Okay, yesterday I posted a trade which I took on Aussie New Zealand. Right, I took the trade. Let me just go through. If you go to my YouTube, I think you should be able to see those trade. Now remember, I was before all this move, right, it was, I can see that clearly Aussie New Zealand was trading in the range, and my bias is up. Actually, my bias that this Aussie dollar is up. So what I was doing, what I was thinking that time was yesterday, or was I was looking to long, right? I was looking long. Okay, let me take off this all the red. So before you see the red circle, those are all not yet happened, right? So I was looking to long, and I saw there is before this candle spike down, I see there are a lot of low here. All right. So I told myself, okay, let's put my buy limit here, right? And maybe put my stop loss below this candle low. Okay. And later on I realized that, well, more lows here, multiple low, right? Triple lows. So I know that if there are a lot of lows below here, multiple lows, obviously other retailers can also see. That means to say that there are plenty, millions of stop loss below this three low. So then I changed my mind, right? I changed my mind, and I think, well, instead of putting my buy limit here, why not I put my buy limit below this low? Right, together with the stop hunting. So this is just stop hunting, but to me, this is my entry, right? That was my initial thought. But then again, I said, well, what if the price just come down just short of one pip and then it go up? Then I miss the trade. So I want to cheat the market a little bit. I put a little bit higher than this low here. And true enough, the price came down, right? It took my order and go all the way up to this target. So now is let's take a look at this same pair again, right? Now, if I take a look at this pair right now, okay, I can see that there are a lot of stop loss here. Now it shows that there are triple bottom again. So again, I know there are a lot of stop loss below here, right? And price likely to come down, right, to do stop hunting. Then at the same time, if I take a look at all this, there are plenty of stop loss below all the candle low here. Now, all these stop loss are actually sell order. These are all sell order, right? So now, if I am the institutions, right, let's go down, go up to higher time frame. Let's say go up to daily time frame. If I am the institutions and I want to move the price down to this area, let's say I'm the institution, I want to move the price down to this area. Okay. Now, for me to sell, right, to sell, put in sell order, right, I will, as the price moves down, I will face a lot of resistance. Now, people will come in to buy, hoping the price to scoop up, right? If I have the buyers that I want to continue to push the price lower, I will continue to see buyer comes in. Right, and I need to absorb all these buyer in order to move the price down. Now, this kind of exercise to a institution, it will cost them a lot of money, because every time they push the price down, someone will come in to buy. So in order for them to continue to push the price down, they have to absorb all the buy order. Right, so unless they have a huge, 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 unlimited source of supply of money, right, they can become a bankrupt, right? So what they will usually do is something like this, right? Now we go to the lower time frame, you can see very clearly. These are all the low that previously the institution has already set up. They set up on this low, why the price come here and stop there? Who stopped the price there? It is not the retail trader who stopped the price there. And the price come down again, stop there, almost the same level. Price come down there, stop there, almost the same level. So now I want to show you this. This is very important. You need to understand this. Now we have a triple bottom. Now, when the retail traders see a triple bottom, they think that this is a very strong support, right? So when the price come down, right, in a lower time frame, they will go in to buy and put their stop loss below the low, right? So if they buy, their stop loss is a sell order, right? So before the price even go higher, they already plan for the future, what they're going to do. This is their future plan, just like Singapore government, right? They plan 10 years ahead, 20 years ahead, right? They don't plan like next year, what we're going to do, next 5 years, what we're going to do. They plan far, far ahead. So institution traders also do the same thing, right? Before the price, before they took the price up to test the high here, they already set up the trap, right? They set up the trap. Why? They see all this. What do you think that, why suddenly the price make a low? And then make almost a similar low here and create a double bottom. Why? Because they want retail trader coming to buy and put their sell order below, which is their stop loss. All right? And price come back again. You see, more sell order, more sell. Why do you think the market, why price stop there exactly the same level? Who made the price stop there? It is the institution intentionally stop the price there so that to induce buyer to give the impressions that this is a very, very strong support. So encourage more buyer to come in to buy and put their sell order here. Now, why do you think they want to do that? Because they know that they will need to bring the price from here down, right? They want to bring the price down. But when they want to bring the price down, they do not want to use their money to absorb all this buying in future when they want to move the price down. They want the retail traders sell order to help them to move the price down. And because there are so many sell order, these are all the stop order, right? Because a lot of people buy and the price goes up, right? So all these are the sell order, which eventually will help the institution to move the price down. Not only down, it's going to go down very, very fast, right? So mark my words, today is 19th of March. When this price drops, it's going to drop down very, very fast. Something like this. Very furious. Fast and furious. That you were never able to catch. All right? Now, of course, today we have just I've just shared some more opportunity in our trading room. If this is something that you are interested, I welcome you to join our community. All you need to do is just click the link. If you are new in Forex trading, and you can always pick the DIY. Come with a very low price, and with this DIY package you will have 3 months of free attendance to my trading room, where you can see this kind of daily update and look for a trade together with me. When I see trade, I will share in the trading room, and you can always follow. All right, and on top of the 3 months trading room that you will have, you will also have this one-on-one coaching with me whenever you are ready. But for this special DIY package, you are getting all this for free. All right, so if this is something that you are interested, welcome to our community and pick your plan today. See you.